Hi, I'm Bonnie Barker with BonnieBabeCrochet.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make the braided bottle holder. Okay, this particular bottle holder fits well over the standard plastic bottles, and you can pull the strings tight, and it fits it very well. It also works on the larger bottle holders, although it doesn't come up all the way up to the top, which I don't really require. But it really makes a nice cover to absorb the moisture, the condensation that occurs when you're drinking a nice cold drink. Okay, I've really enjoyed the fact that it keeps things from leaving a puddle or a ring. It's a really nice thing that I've gotten in the habit of using. Well, anyway, what you're going to need one skein of yarn. Today I'm going to use Lion Brand's cotton. This is a worsted weight yarn. There are many other types of cotton you could use. This particular skein has approximately, I think it's 182 yards. Let me ver 186 yards, excuse me. And let's see, you're also going to need a size G crochet hook. Okay, size G or size 6. And I recommend a yarn needle to hide the loose strands, and you might want some beads. I mean, this is an optional thing, maybe just one or two. I ended up using 12 because I really like these wooden beads. You may even want to use some of the plastic shinier beads, I think, that I'm gonna go for my next bottle holder right here. Well, let's go ahead and get started. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is start with a chain 4. So go ahead, do the slip knot, chain 1, 2, 3, 4, and then it's to join with a slip stitch to the first stitch of the round. We're just making a small circle to work in right here. Okay, do a little slip stitch, and then I have what I like to refer to as a donut seed here, or a little Cheerio. And we're going to chain 1, and now we're going to work 8 single crochets in the ring. 1, 2, 3. Now, as I do this, let me show you what I'm doing. I'm also taking this opportunity to hide this little string here, so I don't have to fool with having to hide it later. If I can save me, some time, I definitely want to do that. Now, let me see, how many stitches do I have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now I need one more. This will be 8. And I'm going to join with the slip stitch to the very first single crochet, which is right here. Okay, now I'm going to begin round 2. We're going to chain 1, and we're going to work 2 single crochets in each stitch around. We're just making our circle here. So 2 stitches in every stitch around. And this will double the number of stitches, obviously. We will have 16 single crochets after this round. Okay, now it looks like this is a stitch to crochet in, but I believe that is the join. So let's double check and count this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. This is a common error with a lot of crocheters. They'll think that this is a space to crochet in, but actually that's the stitch where we joined the last one. So we're just going to join to the top. And always a good way to check to see if you needed to crochet there is to count, like I just did. Okay, for round 3, we are going to single crochet in the first stitch, which is the same stitch as joining, and then 2 single crochets in the remaining stitches. Okay. All right, so 1 in the first stitch, and then 2 in the remaining stitches. I'm going to put 2 in each stitch and crochet all the way around, and then I will show you the join. Okay, I've counted that make sure that I have 31 stitches all the way around. Now I'm ready to join with a slip stitch to the first stitch of the round. Now we're at round four already. We're going to chain two, one, two, and it says to double crochet in each stitch. So I'm going to work a double crochet where I started, and I'm going to work a double crochet around just one per stitch. This is the part where it's going to start looking like a tube. It's going to start going, you know, upward like a cover would you would expect. Okay, let me go ahead and finish this round. Just one double crochet in each, and then I'll return. Okay, now we're ready to do round five. Okay, we're going to chain three, and I'm going to skip the first two stitches, and then I'm going to front post double crochet around the next two. That's one, and two. Now working in front of these last two stitches, I'm going to front post treble crochet in the next two stitches. One, two. Now I'm going to also front post treble in the next two double crochets right here. One, two. Okay, now I want to double crochet in the next two stitches. Now when we do this, we want to make sure that we're not using the same stitches more than once, okay? Because if we do, our stitch count will get off in a hurry. So one, two for those double crochets. Now we've just used this stitch, so let's not use this one, okay? Again, so we're going to skip the next two stitches and we're going to front post treble crochet in the next two stitches, just like we've already done. This is repeating what we've done. Then we're going to front post treble in the two that we skipped. Now we're also going to do the next two here. One, two. Do be really careful about these, because I have actually made some mistakes on reusing some of these stitches. Okay, so go ahead. The next two stitches, we do double crochets. One, two. Okay, now we're going to skip the next two stitches. Now we've already used this stitch. Okay, so let's not use that one. We're going to skip the next two and then front post treble and the next two. One, two. If you need any stitch help, support on doing front post trebles if you've never done that before, please feel free to check out my other videos. I have videos that are very short and are just of specific stitches on the Bonnie Bay Crochet YouTube channel. Okay, so now we're going to do front post treble in the two stitches that we just skipped. All right, and then we do the next two that are in line for the braid. And now to do the next two, we're going to do a front post, a double crochet through the tops. Notice that the double crochets are just worked normally through the two loops at the top, whereas the post cables are worked by wrapping the hook around the stitch like so. Okay, although we're going to skip the next two and then we just wrap it around. It's like kind of like giving it a belt. Okay, and then go back and do the next two that we had skipped, working in front of the last two that we worked. And then we do the next two stitches. Okay, now you should have one stitch left, which is right here, and we're going to work a double crochet there. And don't worry about another double crochet, because this chain is actually going to serve as a double crochet. So what are we going to do? We're going to double crochet in the last stitch, which is what we just did. And at the top of this pattern, it does have in the pattern notes, at the end of each round, join with the slip stitch to the first stitch of the round. So the first stitch of the round was actually the treble crochet. So we're going to just do a slip stitch like this to the top. And see, this way, these two stitches actually do look the same as the two spacers, let's say here. Okay, So they will serve in this pattern. This chain three is going to serve as a double crochet. Okay, now we're going to begin round six. This is using the back post trebles. We're going to chain three. We're going to double crochet in the first double crochet. We're not going to join. We're not going to double crochet in the join. We're just going to double crochet in the top of the first real double crochet there. Okay. Now we're going to skip the next two stitches. Now I'm going to show you from the back side what I'm doing here. Skip the next two stitches and we're going to back post double crochet in these two that are leaning towards us. Use your fingers if you can. Your fingers are smart and they can, you know, learn to feel just what where you need to be on these stitches. Let me try that again. Okay, it's the stitches that are kind of leaning towards us. The next two, I'm doing back post double crochet, going around the back side instead of the front. Now I'm going to back post double crochet in these two stitches, but I'm going to do it in such a way that it crosses in the front. So if you lean around towards the back, these stitches should cross in the front when seen from the front side, just like this. Believe me, it's easier when you try this than what it looks like right now. Now those are the first four stitches. Now stitch five and six are a little bit hidden down here. You're going to have to kind of dig for them, but don't skip them by any means. Once you get the feel of this, again, use these two fingers to let your fingers do the, you know, the walking or the talking or whatever. Now we're going to do the next two double crochets. Again, just working in through the top like we did with round five. Now we're going to do that all over again. Skip the next two stitches, which are these two. And we're going to first back post double around these two that are leaning towards you. Okay. It does seem like a far distance to, you know, to breach with your hook when you're doing this. But once you get used to it, you'll get the feel of it. And now we're going to do the two that we skipped. But again, working so that it crosses on the back side. Okay. I'll try to slow down a little bit. Now these were going for the hidden two, which are right here. They're leaning more this direction. I would say towards the left, but if you're watching this left-handed version, it would be leaning towards the right. So I'll just motion the direction so that everybody understands. Nobody gets left behind. All right, and we're going to double crochet in the next two. Halfway around now. We're going to do that two more times. Skip two. And the two that are leaning towards us, we're going to back post double crochet around those. Now looking for these two that we skipped. And again, we are working back post treble crochets. But you see, when you look at it from the back side, they do cross in front. Now we're looking for the two hidden ones, which are hiding right down here. It's easy to miss these, so want to make sure you go hunting for those before you go on to the double crochets. Now we're going to double crochet in the tops of the next two stitches. That's one, two. Now we're ready for another cable. One, two. We only have four cables here in the round. Back post treble. Again, around the ones that are leaning towards you from the back side. Working in front of these two from the front side. We're going to back post around these two. Okay. And go for the hidden two, which are down here. Sorry about that. And now we've just got we finished. So now we've run into the turning chain. So let's just go ahead and join the top of the double crochet like that. Okay. Now we're going to chain three, turn or turn, and then chain three. Now we're working from the front side again. Now from this point on, round 7 through 18, we are simply repeating rounds 5 and 6 that I've already shown you. So I'm going to begin round 5. Let's go ahead and do this. And then I'm going to send you on your way to do the repeats of rounds 5 and 6. If you have trouble repeating these, please, you know, feel free to back up the video and take a look at these. So from the front side, we're going to skip these two, the two that are leaning, you know, this direction. We're going to treble crochet around those first. Working in front of these two, we're going to front post treble and the two we just skipped. And now we're going to treble, front post treble in the two. And again, these are going to be a little bit hidden. See, they're a little bit hidden behind the first two stitches that we just worked. Okay, let's get some more yarn going here. And now we're going to double crochet in the next two. I'm going to do the braid one more time for you. And then I'll return with more completed. All right, we're going to skip these two, front post treble around the next two. These are the ones that are leaning in that direction. Now we're going to do the two that we skipped. And then we're going to do the next two that are always going to be a little hidden. Okay, make sure you go hunting for those. And double crochet in the next two. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do this all the way around, and then I'll show you how to join. Okay, I've gone around all the way. Okay, which series of four braids and the spaces, the double crochet. Now I'm going to slip stitch in the first stitch of the round, like so. Chain three. Okay, I'm going to turn. Now I'm going to begin a repeat of round 6, but this is actually round 8. This is one of the 6 repeats that we're going to do. I'm going to double crochet the first double crochet, and then we just begin, skip two, treble, back post treble crochet around the next two, the two that are leaning towards you. And now we're going to work in front of the two stitches from the front side, or with the front side, and we're going to work these two. Now we're going to turn to look at the front side, and that's where they are crossing. It's actually in the back as we look at it, but I'm just staying true to what it's going to look like from the front. Now that we've done the first four, we do the two remaining of the braid, and these are the ones that are hidden. The last two are always hidden. You have to go searching for them. Okay, and then we do double crochet in the next two, working through the top. All right, let me just take a look at what we've gotten so far. Okay, this is what we have. I still need to complete round 8, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to have you just go ahead and complete rounds 7 through 18. Again, this is row 8, so finish through round 18. And then I'll show you what I have. Okay, now that I've finished through rounds 18, I wanted to show you what I have here. I've put it on a standard size water bottle. Some people like to, you know, carry these, and I know many of you may not. Maybe many of you'd like to use a bottle like I do. I like to use the same bottle. I just wanted to show you the size difference. Okay, this is a 24 ounce bottle. It does not cover it completely, but I still like that because I have my handle up here to carry the bottle. With the pull strings, this stays on secure. And what I really like is that this does keep the condensation from going anywhere. It absorbs it because it's 100% cotton. And I also just wanted to show you what this looks like, you know, on a recyclable plastic bottle. At this point, suppose you don't like it up this high, you can always take out a row or a round or two. But I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to crochet the last round, which is going to have the space for the pull string, and it's going to bring it up to the top right up here. Okay, let me go ahead and do that. Now we're going to go ahead and chain four. I've already got one, two, three, four. We're going to skip the next double crochet, and we're going to double crochet at the next. Chain one, skip the next stitch, double crochet in the next stitch. We're going to do this all the way around. So it's providing a chain one, skip the next stitch, double crochet in the next stitch. Okay, so what we're doing here is, you know, we're making spaces for our strings to be woven through as pull strings. I'm going to go ahead and finish this round, and then I'll show you after I'm finished. Now that we've worked this stitch all the way around, I'm going to do my last chain one, and I'm just going to work a slip stitch, just kind of loosely, in that chain four, like so. I'm going to chain one to finish off, and get my scissors, leave a nice strand. Careful not to cut thyself, and let's pull that on through, give it a little tug. It's ready to be hidden. Okay. So let's go ahead, and now we're ready to work on our strings that get woven into the top. Now I'm going to make two strands, approximately 65 chain stitches long. So just doing the simple chains. That's five. That's 10. I'm going to go ahead and do this until I get 65 chains. Now that I have my two chains, let me show you my two strands that are 65 chains long. I'm going to take this and I'm going to make this one side. These two double crochets in between the cable will be one side, and this will be on the other side. I'll just go ahead and show you what I'm going to do. I'm going to You can do this a number of different ways, so I'm just going to go in and out between the stitches like this. Okay, don't weave in this end yet. Wait till we get to this next point before you do that. So I'm just going to go in and out, all the way around until I come to where I first started. Out. Okay, so there we go. So this is where we went in, and this is where we come out. So I'll show you what we have here. We'll look at it from this direction. We've gone all the way around, okay? I put this in there because that's a little confusing, so look at that right now. I'll hide that in a little bit. Okay, now I'm going to get the other strand, the other chain that I've made, and I'm going to thread that in my needle like so. This is the opposite side of where we entered over here, and we're going to just go ahead and we're going to follow the same pattern. Like we went under here, over this, we're just going to follow the same pattern as we did with the other chain. Okay, try not to lose that. And I'm going to go over and under. Let's see, make sure we can do that. Yep, it works out. Over, under. We're going to go all the way around until we come to the place where we started with the second strand. which is right here. Okay, so now that's good. And we know we did it right when we can take both strands in hand like this and pull tight, okay, so that we can have the top tightly around where we need it, whether it be a bottle, really of any size. And this cotton is very versatile. It will stretch. Okay, let's go ahead and get some beads to put on the ends and finish off these loose strands. Okay, I've picked a couple beads that I'm going to put on this. And what I'm going to do is I just threaded the strand. And I'm just going to pull them through. Now, notice that some of these beads have, rather large holes, because it needs to be large enough to pull this through, but not too large that it's going to slide off once we knot it. So I'm going to go ahead and put that one there. And let's see, I'll go ahead and put this other pink one here. If you want to use beads, you don't even have to do anything like this, but I just think it's kind of fun to have something kind of pretty on the end of my bottle. If you're making something like this for a guy, obviously maybe go for something more rustic, some wooden beads, or maybe nothing at all. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and try to hide this strand in the string like so. This is going to be it's a little tougher to do this, but we're going to knot it at the end, so it's really not going to show that much anyway. I'm going to pull it kind of tight like this. I'm going to cut it here, kind of close, and I'm going to do a nice little knot on the end, and this is going to hopefully hide our loose strand that's hidden there, and keep the beads on to boot. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and make two knots for this, because the holes and the beads that I've chosen seem a little on the larger side. So I'm just going to make this knot just a bit larger, like so. Okay, and I'll slide my beads down, and there you go. So I'm going to go ahead and do that for all four strands, and then my bottle cover will be complete. Let me show you another thing real quick. Some of you who may have never seen one of my other videos, I want to show you how you can hide the loose strand. I'm going to simply bring this down through the stitch. It's looking a little harder than it really is. It's really not this difficult. Okay, I'm going to bring it down into the other stitches as well. I'm going to try to hide this, and notice that I'm going to try to do this on the back side and just kind of weave it in, however, into some of these stitches down below, like so. Let's go ahead and do that. Pull those through. Not a lot of rules for how you do this. You just want it to be hidden, and you want it to be somewhat secure. So I'm going to go ahead and run it down a couple more stitches, just like so. Okay, pull, give it a little tug. I'm going to go ahead and clip it. Make sure that you do not clip your stitches. You're just trying to clip the loose end. And there, that string is hidden. So let me go ahead, and I'm going to finish these other three, and then I'll show you my finished product. Okay, I finished my water bottle, and I did decide to go with fewer beads to just have less hanging there. I wanted to let you know that if you wanted to make your water bottle smaller, you can do that. If you want to make it larger, you can do that as well. Just add a couple of these, braided cable rows, and you can adjust it to however you like. This will fit bottles that are bigger also smaller, again, just by adjusting how many rows you do. These are great for the gym. If you make it less fancy with the beads, it can be a gift for a guy or for a girl. Also, remember that with the 100% cotton, which is very absorbent, which is great for absorbing condensation, it also has a tendency to stretch. It's not a real resilient as far as stretching back like wool is. So keep that in mind. If it's not tall enough, it may actually stretch a little bit with use. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this project. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.